Hello everybody, welcome to episode 3. Eventually I will most assuredly forget which episode this is. Let's go with reload. Yeah, this is a hard choice. We got 4 weapons and only 12 chapters. No, fuck it. One gun. Got too many of those. Would you believe I didn't, when I got this far the first time, I didn't have a single one of these. Because I do. Actually makes this much easier for me. Now I can buy, let's see, where is Seeker White Shell? Let's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Does anybody think I got too much ammo, or do I not have enough? Well, let's see how this goes. Well, I did have fun. For the best fun ever. A one-shot kill. Awesome. Come on, let me through. Lead to the nearest evac.
Attention. This is Director Titan. A station-wide emergency is in effect. In accordance with Titan Station Civic Code, I am declaring martial law. All citizens are ordered to evacuate. Looters will be shot on sight.
Face pack. Awesome. Not that I'm ever going to use it. That's where I get one right in the screen. I can't believe how fast his leg is now. Come on. You gonna come? Okay, where's the next one coming? I think that's a glitch. It's not even hanging on anything. Get on with the percussion. All time punches only. Do not force. Titan station on planet gate 39.5% due to collateral job loss and ongoing collapse of local planet crafting business. Press the Eastern Moon. Please depress all planet. More and more support services go out of business, leaving less and less capacity for planet crafting. Small profit. Bullied solely by the cash influx of scientific research and operations. Human needs and services organization has been spared the brunt of the planet cracking collapse by the pickup in traffic in 7 seconds. Planet cracker docks, ship services, mining supplies, and tool vendors continue to post heavy losses. However, CEC itself has found moderately large work facility in the R&D department of the government. Wow. Okay, now what is that? Seriously? Well, how am I supposed to pick up new stuff? If I can't actually suck at me stuff. Ruby? I don't even remember picking up a ruby the last time. Okay, let's use some of them detonator mines I just got. Gotta be fun. So what does this do? What's the difference between that mode and this mode? What's the difference? Freaking different! Oh well, I'll find out shortly. I love how I can get my ammo back. The best shit I've ever seen. What is your problem? He was alive, man! Thank you. baby. Why are they giving me rivet bolts? I don't have a rivet gun. Do I have a rivet gun? I wonder what the difference is between this. What is in there? Somebody locked themselves in? Anybody else think that was funny? I understand now. I'm out of ammo here. I think I better go quick for this. I think I'm almost to those little kids. Oh no, I'm to that part.
Don't come any closer. You're not getting in. I'm not opening this door for you. I don't care what your security clearance is or what your orders are.
Because I have to open the door.
I'm in it. You're still leaving the door open.
close to talking to me in part one of two. Time passing bursts seem feasible in the decades following the discovery of the unified field theory, which allowed us to control the graviton. In the same manner, we were accustomed to controlling the electron. With the advent of large-scale applications of graviton, planned mining Australian, they had a new tool. Hanging shockwave point drive for in their infancy, so extra-solar mining was out of the question. Maybe the product packing was still unknown. Saturn's new Titan was selected as the sacrifice. Moon harvest was known back then. Saturn was as far from Earth as the consortium was willing to work and still have these work access to timely supplies and support. Okay.
Sprawl infected? How'd this happen? The marker was destroyed, Dana. I destroyed it.
You destroyed a marker, Isaac. Tyman built another one.
On this station? Why?
It's powerful alien technology. Tyman wants that power. Get to the tram. It'll take you to the Cassini Tower's turn thing.
Dana? Damn it.
Wait, what? Oh, there's kids around here. And that is how you use the flamethrower. Same way as the first game. Just use the stun, stun him again, and stun him again. You still can't beat the game with the flamethrower by itself. You can just conjunction it with the Ripper. And you pretty much are invincible. You will never run out of ammo. Shut up!
Ah!
I deserve that one. I deserve it. So let's try it again. Really bad that time. Ain't it great? Thought I was doing good there for a moment. Okay.